G'day guys, Fitchoke here, and welcome back to my mini-series with Matt212 Hunt vs. Lauda. We are here for episode number 3, at the midway point of this 5-round championship. As it stands right now, it is 1-1, and I am back in the Ferrari today as Matt jumps back into the slightly more difficult-to-drive McLaren as we head to Paul Ricard. Obviously, the version of Paul Ricard we have here in 2018 with all the runoff areas is very, very different to what they had back in 76, but the layout is fairly similar, so it should be a good race nonetheless.
Here we are then, France. I'm looking forward to this one. Hopefully, I don't die in qualifying like I tend to.
I just want to
There's no guarantee, really, is there?
I just want to point out Matt's done what, 2 career mode races around France so far. Is that right? 2?
Probably.
Yeah, I haven't
but
done.
No,
I haven't
in a car,
done one.
Nothing like this.
I think the most laps I've done at this track is probably a 5-lap race on sprint mode, so I feel like I'm at a slight disadvantage, which is general track knowledge, for this this race. Excuses out of the way, we're underway for our qualifying laps. Yep, that's a missed apex.
I have no idea as to where to brake in the corners. Oh, it's been a while since I've driven this McLaren. I mean, we recorded this each week by week, so...
Oh yeah, that's a good dose of understeer. Love it. Is my throttle pedal a bit too squeaky for you?
It doesn't really bother me because I know how squeaky my wheel stand is.
Oh, you're talking about your wheel stand, yes, that is... Oh!
Ah!
I think
we both made a mistake at the same place.
Yeah, coming onto the back straight
is
a tad scary.
Squeaky.
Whether I break.
Oh, come on, get the power down.
Right, was this corner flat? I wonder. Just send it. Ooh, the back end's coming around. Yep, good enough.
We always race with strict corner cutting on in this series, don't we?
Oh yeah, of course.
As I proceed to cut the next corner.
Shh, cut that bit out, no one will notice.
Edit that out.
Yeah, edit that out.
A weird jump cut. Hot turn, come on! Get in! Oh, that's not quite the line, but we'll go to that.
Up
Colin
to the
just
line,
to power down.
And it is not pole, but I think it was ahead of
it
Matt.
It certainly
so.
Is not pole for me. Where are
Second
you?
Place.
Ah, oh, fourth.
Ooh, okay. We're at the pointy end of the field for once. This is a change. I must have set the AI difficulty wrong this time.
Nah, it's fine. Give us a chance.
Makes us look better. Don't worry. I'll edit that little bit of commentary out. You know.
Exactly.
And there we go, second and fourth on the grid. We've really improved since the previous two episodes of this series. Only 8 thousandths off pole position for myself, and Matt 7 tenths off pole position, but the best McLaren in the field. See, now
easy,
we look like good
easy.
Drivers.
Well, you're not the quickest Ferrari, but I'm dominating Shh. The McLaren field, so... So will the Ferrari keep its streak of dominance in this series?
Yeah, it might be 1-1, but it's 2 points to the Ferrari in terms of the actual machinery, isn't it? Here we go, we're on the grid at Paul Ricard, ready for this French Grand Prix. Round number 3 of Hunt vs. Lauda. The lights are coming on in to first gear. We've got 5 red lights. And it's lights out, and away we go. A lot of wheel spin off the line. Still a lot of wheel spin off the line, even up in third gear. And that's not ideal. I have the AI glitching up my inside by the looks of... Ooh!
Oh! That got close.
I am the host of this lobby. The AI are glitching all over the place. This is, this is not a good sign. I don't
on
feel
the whole,
safe.
They're fairly smooth for me.
That's a map 2-on-2 coming up my inside.
Gotta lick the stamp and send it. Oh, point direction correct, please.
Right, here we go. Into the slipstream of that McLaren. What can I do down the Mistral straight? Into the chicane. Right, you've got a lot more confidence on the brakes than I did down there.
Ah, come on. When you get it right in this McLaren, it's so rewarding, but it's near impossible to get it right. Come on, turn it.
Yeah, that's flat. I punted the AI. Touring car move there, a bit of a bump and run. Gotta do what you gotta do.
Wait, did I ever tell you on the last one James Hunt commented on my video?
Did he?
I mean, not the real James Hunt.
He's dead, so that'd be a bit
different. Someone impersonating James Hunt, yeah. Someone impersonating James Hunt commented on the video.
That's quite
funny. Can't remember what he said now, but... Oh, shut the door there.
That's a bit wide there.
Yep, and you... Oh, what are you doing?! Man!
Dangerous re-entry to the track there.
Like, what? I never even got back on the track.
Oh, I left you about three quarters of a car width to my left, and then you've hit
three
me.
Three quarters of a car width?
Yes.
I don't think that's quite what happened there.
Oh, that's roughly what happened on my screen.
I feel
hey,
the
there ain't no stewards in this series. There ain't no stewards in this series after some of the monstrosities we saw in Monaco, both in the failed attempt when your computer decided to blue screen and the actual one. I don't think stewards exist in this series.
Well, yeah. There's always the element of questionable stewards. What's the next track, Austria?
Yes.
Or is it Italy?
Austria. Yeah.
Come on. Well, these AI now are certainly quite laggy.
Yeah, I've been surprised. Like, in the first two episodes, I've been hosting these lobbies. Oh, don't spin it now. The AI was...
Oh, I've nearly been taken out again! I've been taken out again.
Good.
Well, this is nice.
This is fantastic. This is working
AI,
really well.
AI are as bad as Fitcho in this.
Okay. Cheers. What happened on your screen? I'm curious.
I didn't even try to rejoin the track and you just speared me.
So I came off the track when we made contact on your screen.
You tried to. You sort of just turned in on me.
Because I was still completely on the track on my screen. I'm fairly sure. 100% on the track on my screen.
Yeah. Still holding on to a wonderful P11 though. That's all that matters.
Quality stuff there. I am holding on to second place.
Holding on or ramming other people off for second place?
Holding on right now. Definitely place. Holding on to my car through that corner.
I managed to pick up two warnings from one corner there. That's a good going. Does the glitch around here still work?
Oh, here we go.
The track and you
bloody hell. I'm just waiting to look at the minimap and just see you trying that.
It's tempting. I'll be entirely honest.
I'm expecting you to do it now.
Thing is, I don't know if it gives you a penalty at the end of the lap, so I may have to just gamble it on the final lap.
Might be worth a go. You got nothing to lose, right? As I've just taken the lead of this race.
Well, I'm not going to win this one anyway, so let's see what happens.
Oh, he's going for it. Full cheat strategies are coming out here.
I feel we may have sort of lost the spirit of this mini-series, but hey-ho.
just a little bit, you know. Nothing major.
Oh, no, I got a 10-second time penalty. Oh, I got another one. I got one for cutting and then one for rejoining.
Oh, that, that's...
Just giving me a talking to now. Can keep up with his shenanigans, you're gonna get disqualified.
Are you now? Right, wouldn't that be a sight to behold? It's negative points for being disqualified, right? Yeah.
Oh, what? I don't think it is.
Do you not? New rule I'm putting in place right now.
I got a 10-second time
Matt
penalty.
Matt 200K was disqualified for this.
Because I got a 10-second time penalty because I lost the rear end at the final corner down the front straight and then rejoined the track.
Blatant cheating, let's be honest, but well-deserved penalty.
Oh, obviously. Right, let's have a look at you then. Let's have a look at your perfect track limits in the laggiest fashion I've ever witnessed. That, there's an apex through there, I've heard. Rumour on the street.
Oh, really? Where was it? I couldn't see it. Must have missed it.
Cannot believe I've been disqualified. Oh! Oh! Watching this with lag is even better.
Yeah, that's a quality line right there for myself. Oh shit, I thought that was the final lap. I can't count to five, clearly. That could have been very awkward right then. Oh. Oh dear. Oh dear.
Oh, that's going in my edit.
Cheers. I will say in my defense, I have been a bit lazy and I can't be arsed moving my left hand off my H pattern, so I am driving one-handed. Making the car slightly more difficult to control. Right, flat out through this right-hander with one hand on the wheel. Sounds easy, right? Oh, and around the outside of the AI. Quality overtake.
Hey! Through the final couple of corners then, it's gonna be Mr. Lakelane who, well, I wouldn't exactly call it a win, I'd call it a not getting disqualified around the French Grand Prix, but we take those risks in this series sometimes. You know, all or nothing Kimi and all that. I mean, Kimi Räikkönen was already racing these cars at some point, to be honest with him, but a laggy fit show crosses the line in style, I must add.
Yes, pure style for my 6th place finish after bottling what should have been a win. We'll gloss over that, though.
That certainly was an interesting race.
Because I don't care I lost to the AI, because I beat Matt 2-on-2, who didn't even finish the race, because he's been a very naughty boy and gone and got disqualified. So that makes it 2-1 to me.
Best lap.
That is a quality lap. I see why you're in the top split of AOR and doing all these eSport competitions. That is some blistering pace right there, Matt.
I must admit, the 1976 McLaren is not my strong point. But there we are then, guys. Hopefully, you know, you have still enjoyed a very interesting race. Next time, it will be at the Austrian Grand Prix.
Think so,
yeah. If I'm not mistaken, so obviously make sure you're subscribed to both of us for that one. But for now, we'll see you guys next time.